Good morning, students. For this standard 7th, I will take the science. And today we will start a new chapter, lesson number 16, Water, a Precious Resource. We all know about water. We use daily in our life water. We use for fresh, first of all, when we wake up in the early morning, we do brush. In that we use water, then for bathing, drinking and all. Water is very precious resource in our planet. If we see, percent of water is there in our earth, but it is ocean water which we can't drink because it is salty. But if we see, there is 2% of water in the earth which is in the form of ice on the glaciers, and only 1% of fresh water that we drink and use in our daily life. So 97% of water is salty, it is in the oceans, but we can't drink it because it is salty. 2% of water is in the form of ice, but that is also on the glacier, so we can't drink it. But there is only 1% of water, fresh water, which we drink and use in our daily life. So, we all know water is very precious resource. Without water, there is no life on the earth. So, we will study about water. Let's see further. First of all, we will see forms of water. We all know the three states: solid, liquid, and gas. So, if we talk about water, then the solid form of water is known as ice. We know that in the summer season, at our home, in fridge, the water trays are put and it converts to ice, and in liquid form it is known as water. In gaseous form, water vapor. Water vapor. So these are the three forms of water. So, if we see chemically, there is water which is at our normal temperature. We will see a temperature like 25 to 30 degrees Celsius. It is water. Then, if we cool it less than 0 degrees Celsius, then it forms ice. If we will heat it more than 100 degree Celsius. It is known as water vapor. So we can say water is converted to ice when we cool the water at 0 degree, less than 0 degree Celsius, it converts to ice. If we heat water more than 100 degree Celsius, so it forms water vapor. Now we all know the boiling point of water is 100 degree Celsius. We all know na? Okay, if we heat in winter season, we all know water is to be heated, so only we can take the bath. So mummy puts water in one vessel and turn on the gas. So if there is more time heating, then if we see the vessel which is covered with some dish or something, we will see some droplets of water over there. So it is formed water vapor and it settled down in the upside. Next, now the solid form is at glaciers. Solid form of water is in the glaciers, and the liquid form of the water is in rivers, ponds, etc. Now gas form in water vapor and in steam and in fog. So we will revise it. Forms of water. Solid form of water is known as ice. Liquid form of water is known as water. Gas form of water is known as water vapor. See, now if we have to convert water to solid, say from liquid to solid, we have to cool it less than 0 degree Celsius, so it converts to ice. And if we want to convert water to water vapor, we have to boil it, which is known as water vapor. And the solid form of water is seen in glaciers, and liquid form of water is seen in river, ponds, and etc. And gas form of water we can see as water vapor, steam, or fog. Now next, now we will see water cycle. So first of all, what is water cycle? Water cycle, see, I will teach you in the simple form. There is water in the oceans, we will say sea. And in the summer there is lots of heat, so the water is evaporated and forms cloud. Cloud. So due to the air, this cloud will come in the city area, rivers, or in the anywhere on the there, comes out of sea, and this cloud comes here. As we all know, there are three seasons: summer, monsoon, and winter. So in the summer season, the sea water is evaporated and forms a cloud. When the summer season overs, the cloud comes here and it rains. Suppose these are clouds and it rains. So now this cloud, it will rain from the cloud. So the sea water is converted to cloud. Clouds come here and it rains. So we have built some ponds, rivers. There are rivers. Rivers comes from the mountains. So then after the unused water goes back to the sea. So this is a water cycle. The sea water in the summer evaporates and forms cloud, and this cloud, due to the pressure or high pressure and low pressure, the clouds comes here and it rains, and then from this water the ponds and rivers are filled, and then the unused water goes back to the sea. This is the whole process of water cycle. Okay. Now we revise a water cycle by doing it again. So with a nice diagram, this is sea. In the summer season, the water from the sea evaporates and forms cloud. So, okay, we will draw a sun over here. So the sea water evaporates and forms a cloud. Okay, then this process is known as the water from the sea is vapor. Water, it forms water vapor and forms a cloud. So this process is known as evaporation. The process of converting water into water vapor, it's known as evaporation. Then when the clouds form, then due to the high pressure, low pressure, the clouds travel over here in the land. So this is cloud. Then there is, in the land there is mountains, rivers. From the mountains the river comes. And we built some ponds. Okay. in. Now the when the clouds, what the sea, water of the sea evaporates and forms a cloud, then this cloud travels to the land, and this cloud rains in the land. So there are some reservoir trees which, like ponds, dam, we put a dam in between the river, so we can store water. Then the when the mountain in the mountain when the rain happens, it forms a river, and we build in between a dam, so we can store water. And also the ponds, when it rains, this water travels to the land, and the unused water goes back to the sea. This is the whole water cycle, and this process is known as water cycle. The water travels from seas to come back to the sea. This whole process is known as water cycle. Okay students, now we will see the sources of water. First of all, I would like to ask what are the sources of water? Sources of water. Sources of water. Okay, there are two types of sources. First, the groundwater. And second, underground water. So what is groundwater? The groundwater which we can see, the groundwater which is in the sea, this is known as groundwater. Sea, lakes, ponds, rivers, this is the groundwater. And underground water, it is inside the soil. This water is inside the soil, so it is known as underground water. But we all know the underground water we takes out by some we can say that dark, as we all know, the dark which takes out the underground water and gives us. So I will draw a figure of groundwater and underground water. The groundwater is also known as surface water. Surface. Okay. Now I will now tell you about groundwater and underground water by drawing a figure. First of all, ground or surface water. This water, what do you mean by ground water or surface water? So the water which can see with our naked eyes. So what we will see? We can see rivers. Sorry, first of all we will write sea, then rivers, lakes, ponds. So groundwater or surface water is the water which we can see with our naked eyes. So we can see sea, we can see there is a sea, we can see there is a river, we can see there is lake or pond. Okay, now you can see. So I will not draw a figure of surface water, because we all know that we can see there is a sea, river or something, sorry, lakes, ponds, we can see. Now we will study underground water. Now we will see underground water. So underground water, I am writing a definition by my own. There is this definition I am not in the books. So if you have to write, then you can write for your understanding. But I am writing the simple definition by which you can know what is surface water or groundwater or what is underground water. Okay? Now, the groundwater. The water which we cannot see with our naked eye. So the water which we cannot see with our naked eye is known as underground water. So I draw a figure of underground water. So this is the layer from here. This is the ground, and underground means beside the soil or under the soil. This is soil. So the water, the water which is stored in the soil is also known as underground water. We will write the definition. The water which is stored in the soil is known as underground water. So now we will see, today we will revise all the things what I have taught you. So first of all, we have seen that how much water is there, means on the earth how much water is there. Okay, then we have seen the forms of water. Forms of, sorry, First, I will like to write introduction. Introduction in which we have studied how much of water is there and how much in the sea, how much percent is in the glacier and forms of ice, and how much is fresh water that we can drink or use in our daily life. So I would like to as introduction, and then we have seen forms of water. So, in the forms of water, we have seen there are three forms of water: solid, liquid, gas. In the solid form, the form of water is known as ice. In the liquid form, the form of water is known as water. And in the gas form, the form of water is known as water vapor. And then we have studied water cycle. Water cycle. In water cycle, we have studied that when the sea is in the summer season, sea water evaporates and forms the cloud, and due to the low pressure, the cloud comes to the land and it rains. So we store the water, and the unused water goes back to the sea. This is the whole water cycle. Okay. Then we have studied sources of water. Sources of water. In this we have studied two sources: groundwater and underground water. Groundwater is also known as surface water. So it is the water which we can see with our naked eye is known as surface water or groundwater. And underground water, the water which is in the with the form of soil, this is known as underground water. The underground water comes out by the gas which are fitted. Okay, now we will I will give a homework of you few questions that you can easily find from the textbook, or you can also Google it. So I am just asking, I am giving the homework from the textbook only. Okay, now homework. Your today's homework is you have to write down water cycle in your own words and draw a diagram. Okay. Your today's homework is write down water cycle. Sorry, I have forget to written cycle over here. Water cycle in your own words, not what I have said. Just what you understand, then you can write 2-3 paragraphs, whatever you can write, and draw a nice diagram of it. And please send this pic to in the group of your standard. So now we will say over the video. Okay, stay safe, stay home, bye.